Hey, what's up, guys? How you doing? Welcome back. It's part number three, so hopefully this time I'm not going to have any issues. I'm not going to have any problems, because the last time I did a part number two, I was having all sorts of problems with my Oculus Rift tracking, and hopefully it works this time. You know, I'm hoping. I cannot promise you anything, because I'm not a god of technology. So if something goes wrong, it's beyond me. All right, so let's continue this, shall we? Let's go ahead and do this really quick. Graphics quality, it's all the way up.
Nice.
All right, that should be good. I'm gonna do some tracking testing over here really quick. I'm gonna lean backwards. I'm gonna lean forward. Stretch my arms a bit. Let me see. Alright, seems to be working fine. So, no issues so far. Everything seems to be running smooth. And we're gonna start this. Let's do it. By the way, while I'm doing this live stream, there's another video that's being uploaded. It's a 20-minute video about Splatoon 2 and the Pro Controller, about Nintendo Switch, and also I think you guys will agree, I have the perfect, I at least believe it's the best custom picture settings for Samsung KS8000 for that game and for Nintendo Switch in general. So you guys can check that video out. It should be out like in an hour or something. But in the meantime, let's do this, part number three.
Wilson's heart. It's robotic heart. There it is. Touch you, Wilson's heart.
By the way, Peter Weller is the guy that's the voice you're hearing. It's, you know, the actor. It's a known actor from early 70s, early 80s, and of course 90s. Peter Weller, RoboCop. All right. All right, so the trick here is to use my heart. To use my heart to power up that blinking lamp. You see that lamp over there? That's what we're gonna do next. This is some sort of a darkness spirit that's surrounding this mansion, and me and a bunch of other people that I met on this mansion, this crazy lunatic mansion, we have to figure out what's going on, who's behind creating my heart, and what's up with the darkness, with the darkness. All right, let's get back to this. That's his mechanical heart right there. Ugh. You know, my only negative that I would give this game is the fact that it's a click and point VR. You know, it's perspective, it's cinematic narrative perspective, which is nothing wrong with that. It's just that I think it would have been better if you were able to move around, use your left thumbstick and touch things around, you know, but it's a click and point game, unfortunately, with the VR aspect of it. Okay. Hey, Isaiah Thompson, man. It is a Frankenstein. It does have that noir Frankenstein feel to it. No, it is. It is a Dr. Frankenstein. By the way, welcome to the stream. Now, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go ahead and go to the other room and destroy the darkness. I'm going to use the light to destroy the darkness, the spirit.
There's something.
This is a lockpick I'm gonna use to open the door. Once you get a hang of the game, once you understand like how to play it, how to use it, then it's like a second nature. In the beginning, it takes a while to get used to it, but once you get a hang of it, then it's like a second nature. It's really not that hard, honestly. All right, so I'm gonna use this luck pit.
That should do it.
All right, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna use this tool, this automatic screw.
Nice.
This automatic screwdriver, electrical screwdriver. I'm gonna use this electrical screwdriver, and then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go to that fuse box. I'm gonna fix that fuse box. Okay, that's what I'm gonna do now. Hey, Nirva, man, welcome to the chat. From how are you? How you doing, brother? Isaiah and Nirav. Hopefully I pronounced your name right. Is a Nirav and Isaiah. Welcome to the chat, for man. And I'm going to go ahead and turn the power on. Once I turn the power on, then I'm going to go to the other room. Remember, there's this little switch. You press a button to open the door. I'm going to go to that room, and then I'm going to open the blinders so the light will go inside a hallway, which I'm going to show it to you in a minute.
Let's see.
You see now, there's power coming to that door right there. Nirav. So, okay, Nirav. That's how you pronounce it. Nirav and Isaiah. Cool. Awesome, man. Thank you guys for stopping by. Now, let's go ahead and let's kill that darkness. You see that darkness over there? We're going to kill them. You know how we're going to do that? Simple. We're gonna open the shades on the other side of the hallway when I go to that other room, and the light is gonna go ahead and shine into them, and we're going to kill them. Remember how I turned the power back on that fuse box? So I'm going to press the button right here. Voila, the door is open. This could come handy. 'Cause I guess this will come in handy later on. Now, I could run this game like at the higher settings, but currently, because I'm live streaming, I have it running on like a best performance kind of a setting. So there might be some jaggingness. You might see some jaggingness here. That's because I don't want to put too much pressure into my laptop. You know, as soon as I get my Titan X and I put it into my amplifier, then I'll be able to run this at like ultra settings, highest possible graphical, you know, enhancement. We have some gas over here. What I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna turn the gas on.
Let's brighten this place up. There, pilot lights going out.
Well, apparently I'm gonna need some matches or something. Alright, that's where we're gonna find the matches right there. But first thing first, let's open the shades. I'm gonna open the shades so that way the light is going to kill the darkness. Remember that darkness that's on the hallway? We're gonna use the light to kill the darkness by opening the shades. It's gonna be a bit freaky, a bit scary, but don't worry, we're gonna kill the darkness. Are you guys ready for this? All right, so here we go. Let's do this. Alright, so the next step is going to be for us to break that cigar machine and get some matches, okay? And we'll also be able to go into that door too as well. But first thing first, let's do this.
Those could come in handy.
They're bad for you. Don't smoke. You guys want to see something funny? Here. You guys got to see this. This is hilarious. This is a graphic novel. This graphic novel, it's called Hemp. Like a vampire. You know, like a pig empire. Like a pig vampire. Vampire, hence the word pig. Pig vampire. That's some screwed up graphic novel. Here. I'll read it for you. But first, there we go.
Goddamn vampire pigs.
Look at this, man. This shit is hilarious. Vampire pigs, man. I don't know if you guys can read this, but this shit is hilarious. Why? Hemslovenia, my tasty morsel. Yes, very good. My tasty morsel. You get to troops. How cute. Time for the main. Fresh. Delicious. This shit is hilarious, man. I don't know, can you guys see this? Can you guys read this? This is ridiculous. That's the one cool unique thing about this game is you can read as many graphic novels as you deemed necessary.
That's funny.
Let's see what else it says. Hold on. Sniff, sniff. Yes. Now that I've sedated a very old hunger, I think it is time to raise the family. A vampire pig. I kind of like this. I kind of like this graphic novel, Vampire Pig. Let me see.
Good evening, sir. My cousin Larry and I are here to invite you into our family. Perhaps as an uncle. Yes, uncle. What was your name, old timer? Uncle Irma, I would have gone with more manly name, and no matter, welcome him in.
Paper pals, I remember them.
Paper pals. Looking forward for that one. So that's the Hempire, Knight of the Hempire. There's some bunch of graphic novels that you can check out and see. Alright, so the next step is going to be for us to go ahead and go to that gas chamber, use the match, and light the place on fire. Alright, so let's do this. Time to light the matches.
See how this thing likes fire.
Gotcha.